Hi everyone, Michael here. Today I'm going to show you how to create and customize a signature inside of Gmail. A signature usually includes helpful information like your name, where you work, your phone number, and could even have something like an inspirational quote at the end. Let's go check out how this works. To set up a signature in Gmail, go to the top right-hand corner of the UI, click the gear icon for settings, then follow up by clicking See All Settings. Make sure you are in the General Settings area and not in Inbox or Labels or anything like that. Then scroll to the near bottom until you find the Signatures area. You can see here there are no signatures. We will want to click on Create New. I'm going to create a signature for work. I will type in work, then click on Create. Next, I'm going to write in my work signature. Here it is. I can adjust the sizing and fonts of anything written in here, small, large, huge. I can adjust the colors as well if I'd like. Maybe you want to insert the logo of your company. You can do that as well. Move your cursor down to the bottom, then click on Insert Image. I'm going to insert a logo from the company I work at, the Kevin Cookie Company. I will select it and it inserts. It's quite large in the beginning. I will want to move that down to a smaller size so it doesn't stand out too much when I'm sending out emails. After creating a work signature, I want to take advantage of Gmail's functionality that allows me to create multiple different situational signatures. I will want to create one for personal now. I will show you later on how you can divvy up these signatures based on your use case and how you can assign them. But for now, I also want to show you how we can create a signature outside of Gmail, as the tool set in here is actually quite limited. One of my recommendations is to create your signature within either Google Docs or something like Microsoft Word, because you can do a lot more in these programs than you can within the Gmail UI. You can simply create one in here, copy it, and then paste it over into Gmail. My signature has copied over nicely into Gmail. Again, one of the reasons I recommend using those other software programs is because you can take advantage of things like tables, which is how you get a profile picture of yourself to the left or to the right of your signature. Now that my signature is all set up and I've resisted the urge to use Comic Sans as a font, I want to talk about the settings down below. For new emails, right now it says there's no signature, which means your email will go out completely blank at the bottom. If I was writing a personal email, I would opt for the personal signature. And again, for work, it's the same thing here. We would use work. The one I always like to consider is this one here. When you reply or forward your email to someone, do you want your signature to appear? This is really up to you for personal preference. I personally found that when I worked in corporations, I tended to not have my signature on replies because it fills up a long email thread quite quickly. If you're like me, you're probably using Gmail mostly for personal use. I will select the personal signature for new emails. I will not put any signature on for replies. And here it asks, do we want to put our signature before quoted text in replies? This is basically asking, do we want to put our signature above somebody else's text in an email thread, the text that you're replying to? I'm going to leave this off for now. If you leave this off and you do want reply signatures in your emails, then they will end up at the very bottom of the email. Once we're happy with all of our signature settings, I will scroll to the very bottom and click Save Changes. After clicking on Save Changes, this drops us back in the Gmail inbox. If I compose a new message, I can see that the signature for my personal signature pops up right here. This is really nice. I can always choose to delete it manually. Also, you can click the signature in here that you'd like. So if I don't want the personal signature, I can actually select the work signature and it'll change for me automatically. I will say that setting up a signature in mobile is a little different on Gmail, and we will go and take a look at that right now. Inside the Gmail mobile app, everything looks a bit different. I'm in dark mode. To get to settings, I will move to the top left, click the hamburger, the three stripes, scroll to the bottom, click settings, which is the gear icon. Then I will choose the account I wish to use, scroll down just a bit until I find this mobile signature. Here it says it is not set. If I click into this, unlike the desktop or laptop UI, whichever kind of computer you're using, they actually want you to write in your signature right away. You are not naming your signature here. This isn't like you're naming it personal or work. I'm going to put in my signature that will go out anytime I use my mobile device with Gmail, and I say, please excuse any typos, that kind of thing. You've probably all seen this. I will then select OK to save it, and we see it has been set. Back in the mobile UI inbox, I will click compose down at the bottom right, and here we see that my signature has appeared. You can set a signature based on each account you use within Gmail, but unfortunately, you can't denote how you want your signatures to be set, such as work or personal, or even by forward or reply, things like that. And there you have it, a simple and easy way to create personalized signatures in Gmail. So for now, I will be signing off, but please do let us know in the comments how this went for you, and we do look forward to seeing you in the next one.